Welcome to OphirPh, Pearl of the Orient City Guide to Culture. Explore more than 7,000 wonderful paradise island, experience and immerse to the maharlikan culture of Yah. The first cry of Nueva Ecija, Filipino, Sigaw ng Nueva Ecija, Spanish, Grito de Nueva Ecija, occurred September 2 to 5, 1896, in the province of Nueva Ecija, in the Philippines under Spanish rule. It followed shortly after the cry of Pugadloin and was the first call for revolution in central Luzon. Roughly 3,000 volunteers were led by Mariano Lainera and Pantaleon Valmonte, the gobernador silos of Cabiao and Gapan, respectively. They marched towards San Isidro, the provincial capital, where after fighting several battles with the Spanish forces, their army was finally forced to retreat and to undertake guerrilla warfare. Please subscribe in our YouTube channel and follow and like us on Facebook #OphirPh. Visit our website at www.ophirph.com for more cultural city guide. In response to Spanish oppression, the formation of the Katipunan, the Cry of Pugadloin, of August 1896, and the repression that followed, Mariano Lainera led about 700 men from Cabiao, while Pantaleon Valmonte led troops from Gapan. Manuel Tineo, Colonel Alipio Texan, and their men also joined the combined forces of Lainera and Valmonte, with the people of the neighboring towns of Arat, Delicante, San Antonio, and this force numbered 3,000 Filipino revolutionaries, and it prepared to seize the provincial capital of San Isidro. Although the force numbered 3,000, it was only possessed of about 100 rifles. So, the Filipinos organized themselves at Sitio Palu, about 5 kilometers from San Isidro, and chose 500 men for the initial attack, and chose to employ the Cabiao Brass Band B, to disguise the military movement as a peaceful march meant to gain the release of those already arrested by the Spanish. Upon reaching San Isidro, the revolutionaries furiously fought the Spaniards, who defended themselves in the Casa Tribunal and the Arsenal, as well as in other government buildings, and in the houses of Spanish residents. The Spanish commander, Joaquin Macaro, commander of the Guardia Civil, was killed on the first day of battle. At the end of 3 days of fighting, the Spanish were driven out, and the revolutionaries seemed to have prevailed. After the retreat, Lainera, Tineo, and other Nueva Ecijano commanders shifted to guerrilla warfare until they could regroup for another offensive. This tactic, though effective in stalling for time, caused the revolutionaries massive casualties, as the Spaniards furiously pursued them. Generals like Manuel Tineo had to constantly escape from pursuit and hide, as the revolutionaries continued to fight desperate skirmishes against a well-armed and well-prepared enemy. This continued until late December when, for a while, there was no pursuit by the Spaniards and the revolution seemed over. Lainera used this vital pause to regroup for another attempt at revolt. If you have any comments or suggestion, feel free to comment below. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe in our YouTube channel and follow and like us on Facebook #OphirPh. For more cultural city guide, visit our website at www.ophirph.com. Do not forget to click the notification bell.